Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Man the Maker, and welcome to another episode of Certain Death. Let's end the day. I mean, people are hungry. Yeah. Well, the coma has seen better days. In fact, your comas are in a pretty foul mood. Perhaps I can turn things around. Maybe because I have high charisma or something? Charismatic, plus 12%. Can't for the life you change the mood. Worse, you only annoy people when trying. Something ought to go wrong. All day today, you're bombarded by petty, annoying, nagging, silly little problems, one after the other. It's not any stretch of the imagination, but all of this is because of the general poor morale. But knowing the cause does not alleviate the frustration. Minus two resourcefulness. So when things are bad, things get really bad, is what you're saying. And I mean, what am I supposed to do about it? I feel like there's nothing I can do. Success, success, success. I never find anything in any of these places. We actually have not, I mean, yeah, you're all pretty shattered morale. Yeah, because I haven't paid you in 11 days. The comatose morale is dangerously close to being irreversibly broken, and you're quickly losing your chance to turn this around. Yeah, very last chance, high chance of success. We managed to pass. We did not get a bonus. And we're just gonna die out here. Right? Yes. We've got critical successes, but we have not encountered a single thing out here. I'm really not sure. What did I just do? Did I just force march you guys? Somehow? Go to sleep. Rising disobedience from the slaves. Slaves are in part responsible. What are you going to do about it? Try to earn their trust by being lenient with them? Seem to work. The slaves are more docile almost immediately. Plus one obedience. Yep, very last chance. Okay. Okay. What's that? Why can't I go there? I mean, was I supposed to go into a particular place? Was this... that I just totally missed? It doesn't say anything. Capture the outlaw chieftain. But no indication of where to go. The Black Knight. In Arenas Vorax. Which I'm in. But I have found nothing. How the hell? Yeah, we're going to have another last chance, and now we're out of food, folks. Now we are out of food. High chance of success. We passed. It's getting worse. We are absolutely dead. Success and success, but there's nothing here. We now have no more food. Yeah, everyone's pretty upset about things. I have no more movement. We're fatigued. We have no more food. Yeah, I can try and earn their trust again. It's worked again. This is the last day. Low. Test fail. Yep. That's definitely what happened. It's definitely what happened. I mean, where can we even load from? A checkpoint back in Avernum.
With the Black Knight's investigation concluded.
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, I'll try one more time. It's pretty brutal when you don't know what the hell's going on. And they have really no particular destinations. I should go to Utvotar, probably. The deputies panel is now active. Thank you. Thank you, thank you. We'll end the day. Scouting is now active. You want me to scout? Scout at least one direction. I mean, why would you not scout in all the directions? Success, 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 and critical success, but there's nothing there. It shows up here. Oh my god. I might not have really been able to pay attention to that. Keep in mind to pay the due. Yeah, I know I desperately need money. We know that. Oh. Something awaits you here in direction 3. See, I was not paying attention at all to that. I totally missed this. Yeah, well, sleep. This thing that we find better be like a pile of money. I'm sorry. Did I look in the wrong direction? Direction 3, there's something here, it says. It's not like you couldn't hear it from afar. For the better part of an hour now, the silence of the wasteland has been disrupted by the sound of drums. At least a dozen of them. If you'd have to guess, you can't ignore them anymore. The designated route of the comitatus runs too close to the supported location. Let's have a look. Slowly you approach the source of the pounding drums. Accompanied by most of your trusted comrades, you crawl on all fours to the top of a nearby sandhill and glimpse a sight to behold. Down below in a small valley, there is a congregation of orcs. Thoroughly occupied by what seems like some kind of ritualistic impromptu drumming festival. The dark-skinned creatures hammer down upon their crude instruments like there's no tomorrow. Their faces distorted in ecstatic revelry. Maybe we can try and sneak ya? Do we walk straight down to the camp? let's try and steal. High chance of success? Yes! Probably grab as much of the content as you can, as quickly as you can. Nice! Orcish Terror Totem! We have to go here. Hello, Utvotar! Utvarar, home to the eponymous Utvarar tribe of fire worshippers. This village is one of the few permanent settlements the Satyrir folk have. Poised on the edge of a large barren plateau, protected from the raging heat of nearby lava lakes, rows of soot-covered sandstone houses and tents await visitors. Everything is painted orange and red, the holy covers of the great colors of the great fire spirit. Clothes, awnings, banners, and even faces. I can sell some stuff. Doesn't it tell me prices? Highest buy prices in Scrap Heap were very high. And here has the lowest. But not by much. And we only have 2. Oh, a tribal trinket. Some sort of tribal bauble trinket that might be valuable to someone. I also have ivory. 2 ivory. Again, sells for so much more. I mean, so much more in Scrap Heap. We're not going back to Scrap Heap. Last known sell prices. Oh, these are buy? Am I looking at this wrong? Yes. I think so. Lowest sell prices are here. Last seen was Avernum for slightly more. I think we just sell everything we have here. Can I sell pottery? I mean, this sells for 2, and we can sell it for less in Avernum. Right, I need to make money. 7. We can sell it for more in Avernum. But not much more. I mean, not worth going all the way there with just them. Same. Probably not worth it. Deputies, no. Maybe something can happen here. Hire scouts. Cost money. Approach a group of young warriors. Four young Utfarar warriors are talking in hushed tones down next to a row of tents. They greet you politely when you approach them and ask them why they've been staring at you. We heard your tribe travels the sands and may go to faraway lands. The oldest of them says, the fire in our hearts seek... Fire in hearts compel us to seek what is over the horizon. If you wish, we would join your tribe and fight for you. You could hire them if you're looking for a warrior or just play into their sense of destiny and curiosity. Try to get them to join for free? Yes. We failed. Maybe honor, but we still need metal coins to pay for things in faraway lands. So much money. It's everything. It's all we have. Sorry. And the shamans. The fire shamans in the Utfarar tribe are the just undisputed leaders of their people. Nobody would dare provoke their wrath, and rightly so, because they, like the element they worship, they can be fickle and quick to wreak havoc. The daily gatherings of Utfarar's most influential shamans can be attended by outsiders as well. So you trudge over to the Brickwork building where the meeting takes place. Inside, it's hot as a furnace, thanks to the large fire set in the middle under an opening in the ceiling. The shamans sit in a circle way too close to the flame and discuss the important matters of the tribe, as well as listening to news and propositions from outsiders. After a lengthy discussion of what the fire spirit commands, you get the chance to address the shamans. Do you have medical supplies? No? The last pilgrimage. Recount your encounters with the spectral pilgrims. We know little of these wandering spirits because we avoid them just like everyone else. There's a fire burning inside them, but this fire is not of this world. Interesting. I got nothing else to say here. A little bit of money. 7 unpaid days is really bad. How can I pay them in a smaller amount? Oh boy. You want to go to Avernum? What does this mean? I will take you to Avernum. And I will buy all the dyes I can, which is 1. Okay. I don't even want to. Yeah, I mean, I could. I might need to. Because, I mean, we do have to go back to Avernum now. They did do some force marching there, huh? Max movement to max march. Okay, we sleep here. I wish I could pay. I mean, I fear that I will have to pay them with scrap metal money. But for now I kind of know. Okay. Let's check out in this direction. Nothing in those directions. We will force march it. I think that takes away from their vigor, but what are we have to. I mean, we have to make good time. We have to make money from here. Gesundheit! because we owe them so much. We owe them so much money. And we know what happens. The morale is already broken. That's not good. That's really not good. We'll end our day here. We know this one. We will try and moderate them. We failed. We will scout. Four, five, and one. Direction four, there's something. I mean, we should check it out. As Comandos crosses the broken terrain, one of your scouts runs up to you from her forward position. Vagrus, there's a solitary figure standing at the edge of the ravine to the north. I think it's a Satarar tribesman. He's watching the crags, but I couldn't tell if anything is going on down there. Let's see what this is about. Leaving the comitatus behind, you take your companions and some of your fighters over the hills just in case. In a few minutes, your cohort finds the man your scout was talking about. Standing at the edge of a set of ravines is a lone tribesman leaning on a bone spear. His sweat and the choking heat has caused most of his orange and red body paint to dissolve. Over his red poncho and bandana, you can see grim eyes gazing into the crags. The man is clearly Satarar, most probably of the Fire Tribe. He turns to you slowly as you approach him. Lafalk Jaivani, greetings, travelers. The great fire spirit must have sent you in this dark hour. He explains that while hunting fire lizards a few days ago, his group of hunters was attacked by a terrible undead monstrosity. It slaughtered his fellows, and he only survived because he hid like a coward. Now he cannot return until the spirits of his companions are avenged. He's been tracking the undead horror for days, since he figured he couldn't kill it alone. He asked the great fire spirit to send him aid, and you appeared. Clearly enough, you can see a large, dirty gray shape looming down in one of the crags, and several smaller undead. I must go now and face my destiny. If you were indeed sent by the spirits, follow me! With that, he's gone, jogging down to the ravine. Follow him. You and your fighters descend nimbly into the volcanic crags, all the while you're thinking about you going crazy for doing this. Satarar trackers ahead of you, heading straight towards the undead. Time to decide what to do. Attack the undead horrors to aid the tracker? Yes. Plus two resourcefulness. Hey, nice. As your cohort approaches the undead, you can see that there are several smaller smoldering ones and a large pale abomination that looks like it's been fused together from several dead bodies. The tracker engages with a smaller creature while your team takes on the rest. A fight commences. Okay. You in the front, you in the back, you down here. Plan of attack, we're going to try and wreck you. Actually, I might just have her knock you into the back over and over again. We're going to debuff your accuracy. We're going to buff your accuracy. And then we're just going to go to town. Let's go. It's nice that you get to go first. That's not what I want. I want to kick you. But you knock back, right? Yes. And then you're going to move. Perfect. You buff my man up over here. It also buffs yourself. Okay, there's another undead up there. I had not noticed. We will bane you. We cannot use your mind powers against the undead. Crap. He still hit us. This kind of makes me say we want to kill you, actually. I cannot use these against anyone, so I will just have to buff her while she continues to kick this guy into the back. And you miss. Oh yeah! Fortunate that she got knocked back. That's not very useful. I miss again. Time for you to just tear this guy down, please. Yeah, fortunately, he is going to get the attack now. You might as well move up to the front. Okay. A little bit of damage. What is this? Do they make you bleed or something? Fire damage over time. Okay. I have to move you. Two damage is not bad. Primed you to die next turn. Move you back to the front. Now this, it says it does a cleave. I have never actually seen it deal damage. Let's see, 28. You blocked it. Man, crap. Okay, clout with the fire damage. Nice with the miss, thank you. Is he still debuffed? Nice with the miss also. I'm gonna say that he's not debuffed. Let's kick you into the back. As much, I mean, I think it's... We're better off just killing you. Let's not. We'll debuff you next turn. You've got your flail. We block. She takes more damage than I'd like, but she's okay. You can get the hit. Move back here. You missed. Fine. You keep this up. And the miss. We will again use Bane. Really hurt your accuracy. He's out of power. Damn! That did hurt. But, okay, that also not great. She's down. We're bringing her back. Missing the big guy. How do you do that? Exactly. Buff him again. I mean, I'm pretty sure you can probably solo this guy if she gets wrecked again. I wish you would stop hitting her every time. Yeah, she's down again. She is not very good. I'm not gonna lie. Not super good. Okay, finally we're dealing damage to him. Please. Thank you. And now you can get your kick action going on again to at least prevent him from attacking. Please don't kill her. She even has evasion stance, and it's she's just so bad. Devastating blow? Likely, yeah. Morwin, why are you such a disappointment? Oof, it's gonna take a long time to get through the congregated over here. I'm very happy that you're attacking them. Blocked, but it still knocks you back? No. No, it does not. Cleave? Okay, you did hit both of them, and actually that makes a lot more sense. We should just do that all the time. It's fine, he can take the hits. I mean, I think we accept that she's probably going to die again. Zero damage, not great. Continue on with your cleaving, sir. Maybe we can kill this guy. She dodges? No, of course she doesn't dodge. She literally can't do anything, and now we don't have enough points for... Oh, boy. You're also just gonna get behind him now. So if she dies here, she is permanently dead, I think. So little damage. And they just gang up on the dead woman. Can you not move her? What if I gave her premonition? Will that help? I worry that we're just gonna die here. This game, yeah, she's gone. She's out of action, okay. Not dead, for real dead. But I'm pretty sure everyone is going to die. At least that thing is gone. You at least only get one attack per turn now. He's probably out. Yeah. You have 19 hit points to go. That is a significant number. Okay, another one down. It's just you, buddy. Just you. I don't know. Ugh. The miss is not what we needed. Oh, the miss is what we needed. This is really intense. Give me a crit. He's gonna crit me now. We're down to two. Yes! Miss, please God! One hit point left! I swear. He went before me! He went before me? No, oh, that can't be it. I can't believe he went before me. We're gonna do it again. Brutal. But that's gonna be next time. Until then, my name is Ben the Maker. Take care, everybody. Have a wonderful day.